Crossblade versus Invaders. We gotta switch sides.
Also reset the score. Yep. And change the round.
And this is gonna be Loser's Semis. We're starting off on PS2. Tater is opting to go to Pichu.
Yes. And I mean, Pichu won the last set, so, you know. Hey, stick with what's working, I suppose.
Yeah.
Although Falco probably a much more annoying matchup for Pichu. I feel like that back air is going to kill you at like 80, so gotta be real careful. Oh. Yeah.
It was honestly a pretty neat option. He jabbed him off ledge and it made for a tech situation.
Yeah. Yeah,
oh, wow.
That is just the one thing with Tater's Pichu that I really don't like is I feel like every time he's ledge trapping, he just like tries to guess what they're going to do. Oh, he fell out!
Yeah.
Pichu sucks!
I wonder if it was just being high percentage that helped there.
It definitely lies. There was no way Crossblade STI'd that like in that short of a period of time. So, dude, that move is actually like insanely STI-able. If you STI like up, you can like pop out the top if you have good STI. Mm.
I remember Leo versus Esam.
You
Leo
saw how much he moved? Yeah. He still got hit by it, but he moved like an insane amount. Mm. Wow, he died to that. That's... Dude, I don't get how people play this character.
Yeah. It's definitely frustrating dying at 60.
Yeah. Dude, did you see my up smash kill him?
Yeah.
Like literally like 50%. I was like, what? Mm.
Your fair up smash that you said?
I don't think it was fair. I think it was just like he was just landing and on the platform and I just up smashed. But I was at like 160 and he was at 50 or something. Mm. Something. Just killed him.
Yeah.
I was like, what?
I know I've played against Tater's Pichu before and fair to bear him at like 45.
Yeah. Yeah, luckily for me, Yoshi Pichu is like pretty awful for Pichu, I think. So I'm kind of carried in that matchup.
Uh-oh. Down smash is not going to hit the grab.
All right, Holmes, I want to play a game with you, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
The game is predict the ledge option from the player before they
roll.
Do it, okay? Well,
that kind of counted.
Yeah, that kind of counted. He's going to not go to ledge, so that doesn't count. All right, Crossblade electing to not go to ledge again.
Not going to ledge.
Crossblade, go to ledge so we can pick your option.
Ooh.
Okay, he's going to jump. Right. He's going to jump this time, 100%.
All right, if Taters gets close,
that's cheating.
That was tough. I want Taters to be on ledge because I know what Crossblade's doing the first time Taters gets to ledge.
Is he going to do drop off jump side B?
No, drop off jump fair.
Oh, okay, yeah. Luckily, it doesn't really matter what you think he's going to pick because you can just shield and it beats all of those options.
Got the angles.
Oh, wow.
The up tilt, the back air won't connect. Great friendly playable.
Yeah, and this is one of the things that Pichu tends to struggle with. He has really good base knockback on all of his moves, so he can, like, kill you. Is he dead?
Yeah, 198.
Oh, barely.
That's probably good.
But, one thing that Pichu struggles with is he has really high base knockback on his air. He was trying to end him right there, by the way, with that up air. Is he Yao?
Yeah,
he's
gonna kill.
He's Omega dead.
That's going to be game one going to Crossblade.
Let's go, Crossblade.
Sorry, got a chance.
Sorry.
I didn't see what he did into it, probably up tilt, but
it was up tilt back air.
Moral of the story, something in the back air.
Moral of the story,
Falco's kill confirmed.
Don't get up tilted as Pichu at 70,
because
you are Omega dead.
Don't get hit as Pichu.
Don't
at
get 70. Hit, because you're going to do 30 of that percent to yourself.
Yeah.
So you can lose neutral like once.
Mm.
But I don't even remember what I was talking about.
We're playing a game, and then
we were playing the game, and then Crossblade never went to ledge. So.
Yeah, Crossblade likes to side be high. He especially likes to wall jump side be high.
Crossblade is not a fan of going to ledge. He likes to go over the ledge or like try and poke you with up air as he's
sharking.
In. Yeah. I mean, Taters doesn't like ledge either, apparently. So.
Yeah, Taters at kill percent. Gotta be careful here.
Yep,
attacking Crossblade gets the drag down up.
Goodbye.
Yeah, that's going to do it. Even at center stage, up tilt at 83, that is not a good time for Pichu.
Yeah, I mean, that's just the life of a Pichu player, you know.
The down tilt, fair. Not going to get the downer on the side B.
Hitters struggling to find these kills right now.
Oh, that normal getup is going to get caught by Tater's down smash, and that's going to equalize the stocks. Not too much extra credit in Crossblade's favor, of course. We're creeping up on kill percent.
Oh,
right,
nice.
Down fair, he's going to up air here, and that's going to do it off the
top. That was crisp. He, like, waited for the air dodge as well.
Mm-hmm.
That was... That, Mwah.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
The good news is Falco Up Air is really DI-able, but as Pichu, I'm not sure there's much that could have been done.
Yeah, I think you can also DI to make the laser not hit you.
On up throw, yeah.
Yeah. Is it, do you DI in on the throw?
You know, Crossblade showed me a spreadsheet once. I don't absorb information well. It's really weird. It depends on ball speed sometimes, I think. Okay. But some characters have to DI in, some characters have to DI out. It's weird for sense. It's dumb.
Weird. Anyway, Tater's down smashing again, cleaning up that second stock. Last stock scenario, obviously, you know, Pichu definitely can just win pretty much whenever he
tripped
him twice.
That is a power move, 1-9. Pretty much game and watch 9 down, but that didn't kill.
This is really bad
spot. Putting Crossplay in a horrible spot. The fair is not going to connect all of its hits. Wonder if it would have killed 50% out that deep, maybe?
Yeah, I feel like it most likely would have. Okay, he was trying to get the back air, I think, but just takes the fair instead.
Yeah, Crossblade was able to jump over Tater's normal getup, not able to punish that. So, I know Crossblade likes to jump there.
Yeah, Crossblade using the Nair there to stuff out. Tater's trying to jump in a lot with the T-Jolt. And Tater's Crossblade stuffing that out with the Nair. And back air gets him off stage. He goes...
Oh, sec.
He was trying to be reverse uppy, but he messes it up. Oh, God.
That is a relatable misinput, Tater's.
Yes.
Wow, yeah, the drag down forward air to down smash is going to take game two in the favor of Crossblade.
Yes, nice combo from Crossblade. Okay, that combo is definitely fake, though.
Yeah. It's, like, weird.
It works sometimes, but it's not consistent at
all. I know Crossblade told me it's always true on Zero Suit or something. That's really weird, but Falco's got jank. He's got weird stuff that no one understands.
Yeah, he just hits me, and I'm at 80. Like, stop. Leave me alone. But, yeah, I think... at least whenever I'm playing as Crossblade, it feels like as long as I'm shielding at the right time, that does not hit me ever.
Yeah.
Did he switch characters?
Yeah, I think I saw Kirby.
Kirby?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
That's an interesting pick. I'd like to see some footstools out of Crossblade.
I think there's no shot Tater's wins with this character, right?
Yeah, this might just be a showcase. Maybe something he's cooking up for the Arsenal.
I don't think I've ever seen Tater's play Kirby in my life, so... I mean, I can kind of see, like, maybe the matchup being not that bad, because, like, Kirby can kind of cheese you with down air, so... Oh!
Of course, if you catch Falco up being...
It's kind of the same problem, though, where, like, Kirby is, like, Omega Light, so if you get up... But so yeah.
Able to stuff out the beginning of Tater's up B. Gets a kill at 87, I think.
Yeah, and this is where, I'll be honest. Kirby, I hate this character. Like,
yeah.
I think all Kirby players should be, like, relentlessly camped out the entire game. Because this character does not reward interaction whatsoever.
Yeah, I especially hate just when they play on ledge.
Yeah, they just, like, every Kirby player, all they got is the combo. They're like, I know how to do down tilt trip you into, you know, whatever. But, like, neutral? Kirby players are not trying to play neutral.
Yeah. Well, that's going to be an early second stock for Crossplay.
Yeah, and this is looking a little over. Tater's having a nice run tonight for sure, but Crossblade is done with that run. Crossblade's continuing his own run.
Crossblade definitely has his eye on the prize. Nice little dash dance from Tater's.
Yeah, Tater's calling out the illusion. Okay. Nope.
It's gonna go for the back.
Back air will kill for sure.
Up
tilt will kill as
up
well.
Up tilt back air, that's going to do it, and that's gonna be the 3-0 for Crossblade.
Goodbye to Tater's. Good run from him, fourth place. Not too shabby.